Today, our main topic of this video is the transportation across the cell membrane. Substances move in and out of the cell by the two types of transportation system. Number one is the passive transport. Number two is the active transport. Today we shall discuss the passive transportation in detail. So we are going to discuss the passive transportation in detail. The passive transportation is that type of transportation which needs no ATP or no energy, and the substance will move across the cell membrane without the consumption of the energy. So the very first point you have to remember, that this type of movement of the molecules across the cell membrane needs no energy or no ATP. So there are three main types of such transportation. Number one, we have osmosis. Number two, diffusion. Number three, we have the facilitated diffusion. These three types of transportation, or they are the three types of the passive transport. These three types do not require any ATP, or the substance will move without the consumption of the energy. So we have the first type today. We shall discuss first of all osmosis. What is osmosis? It is the movement of solvent molecules, or you can say water molecules, from the region of higher concentration towards the region of low concentration across the semi-permeable membrane. So how can you define the osmosis? It is the movement of the water molecule, because water acts as a solvent in the biological system, so it is also called as the solvent molecules or water molecule. When they move from the region of their higher concentration to the region of their lower concentration, or you can also say that the movement would take place along the concentration gradient. The movement of the water molecule from their higher concentration region to their lower concentration region across the semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane is a membrane that allows some substances to pass through, but it does not allow big or charged substances to pass through. So along the concentration gradient means, because the movement of the water takes place from the high to the low, so it is called as the along the concentration gradient. Because at the one side of the membrane, plasma membrane, the water is in high amount, high quantity, and another side the water is in low quantity. So we can say that the concentration gradient is developed, because one side has high water quantity, another side have low water quantity. So it is called as a concentration gradient. As water or solvent molecules move from the region of high concentration to the region of low concentration, so this type of movement is called as the osmosis. So let us discuss the osmosis with the help of the diagram. For example, this is the semi-permeable membrane. Small pores are here, or fenestrations are here, so that the water molecules will move from the region of their higher concentration to the region of their lower concentration. This is the higher concentration of the water. This is the lower concentration of the solvent or water. This blue color represents the water molecule. There are more water molecules as compared to this side. Okay? So, in the osmosis, the water molecule from the water molecule will move from the region of the high concentration to the region of the low concentration. Okay, like this. The water will come over here. Because the movement is taking place from high to low, from upside, from high side to low side. So it is easy for the molecule to move from their high concentration side to the low concentration side. That's why it does not take any ATP, it does not require any energy. Okay, so the water will move from the area of their high concentration to the area of their low concentration. This blue colored ball is actually representing the water molecule. Now, examples of osmosis. Where does the osmosis, examples of osmosis, where does osmosis take place? Osmosis takes place, first example is the root hair cell. In the plants, for example, this is the cell, this is the root hair cell. This is the root hair cell of the roots of plant. It has low concentration of water. These blue dots representing the water molecule. And in the soil, there is high amount of the high concentration of the water molecule. Because this is the plasma membrane and we know plasma membrane is the semi-permeable. So this plasma membrane is semi-permeable. The water will move from the soil, from the high concentration. Inside this cell, the cell has low water concentration. So there is a low concentration of the water. So again, the water is moving from high concentration to the low concentration. This is the best example of the osmosis. So now in the next type of the passive transport, now the next type of the passive transport is the diffusion. Diffusion is also very simple type of movement. There is no much difficulty. In the osmosis, the water was moving from higher concentration to the low concentration. The solvent was moving from the higher concentration to the low concentration in the osmosis. Now in the diffusion, the solute will move from the region of its higher concentration to the region of its lower concentration across the semi-permeable membrane. I'm again repeating, in the osmosis the water is moving, the solvent is moving, but in the diffusion the solute is moving from the region of higher concentration to the region of the low concentration without ATP, no ATP required. Okay, so in our body, where does the diffusion takes place? The diffusion takes place when oxygen and carbon dioxide is diffusing from the lungs into the blood. Okay, for example, this is the capillary. Okay, it has high amount of the carbon dioxide. This is the carbon dioxide molecules. Okay, and over here the carbon dioxide is less. In the alveoli, the capillary has high amount of the carbon dioxide and over here less amount of the carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide will move from the region of high concentration to the region of low concentration. Similarly, very similar, the high amount of the oxygen in the lungs, for example, these red balls representing the oxygen. In the blood, low amount of the oxygen. So the oxygen will move from the high concentration to the low concentration. From the high concentration to the low concentration. So the best example of the osmosis is the oxygen carbon dioxide diffusion in your body. The food is going to diffuse into our blood. These are some examples of the diffusion. Now in the next video, we are going to discuss the facilitative.